Welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. This is a special video today. It's the 300th video that I've made for YouTube. Now, if you want to see more of my videos, just go onto YouTube, search Enots Engineering and click on my face. Now, today we'll look at a tool review from Banggood. Two items: a dial indicator, a lever type, and a digital caliper, 6-inch. Now let's go to the workshop and see how we do it. In today's tool review, we have two items: the 6-inch digital caliper, and the second item is this dial indicator. We'll start with the dial indicator. It comes in this plastic box. Instructions, the dial indicator, and this is a metric dial indicator. The range is from 0 to 0.4 on each side. It has a yellow background. On the end of the probe is a steel ball. Some of them have a lever on here to reverse the direction, but this one seems to work either way. It has a dovetail on the bottom, on the end, and on the top. And in the box it comes with a dovetailed attachment to hold it, and a screwed to lock it in position. And if you tighten the ring down, that locks on the back. You can move it onto the bottom if you want it coming out the bottom, or onto the top there. It comes with two spare probes. The one probe has a ruby type ball on the end. The other probe has a steel ball on the end. And the probes are all the same length, so they're interchangeable. The adapter that comes with the dial indicator should fit a standard magnetic base, and you can also remove the adapter and the dovetail should fit on the end of a standard magnetic base. The resolution is 0.01. Accuracy is 0.02 of a millimetre. It has a yellow dial. Indicator will go about 1¼ turns, which is about 1 millimetre. That's underneath. You see the dovetail is along the bottom there and on the end, and on the top here. I've got a small surface plate and I've built some slip gauges up. This one is a 1-inch and these two come up to 0.999, so there's a thou difference between the two. And I've zeroed the dial indicator, and from where I'm looking it's on zero, but from where you're looking it's slightly off, but looks like zero. Move it to the other gauge block, 0.027, so it's a little bit out, but the instructions say accuracy is 0.02. So it's probably within
0.005. Now, considering there's a thou difference,
let's say 0.03, half a thou.
Now, it's important on these dial indicators that they're held parallel virtually to the part that you're trying to measure. On these indicators, you get the most accurate reading when this is parallel. If I'd got it set down like that, because you're bringing this, imagine that's a radius, you're coming in closer to the pivot point, so the distance is shortened, so you lose accuracy on the pivot. So the straighter you have this to the centre line, the more accurate you will be with your reading. Now that's a dial indicator. The top will swivel round so you can set your zero wherever you want it. Travel is 0.4 in either direction. And you have the dovetails on three sides. So let's move over to the lathe. You can check small runouts. Put in the ball, bring it down onto the part. And you can go further into the ball. Now, to do the inside of that ball with a standard plunger indicator, you couldn't do it with this type of indicator, because it has to be square to the bore to get an accurate reading. Now, the next item I have is a digital caliper. Comes in a plastic box. Comes with the battery, in this case it was already fitted. On the back you have a conversion chart, different information, Whitworth and metric details. You have three buttons, one's on off, one's to zero it, and one is to change between the three functions. And the functions are millimetres, inches, or fractions of an inch. So if I switch it on, that's in millimetres. When I press this once, that's in inches. Press it again, this will be fractions of an inch. Press it again, millimetres, inches, fractions of an inch. It's made of stainless steel. The LED screen is easy enough to read. Set it to a 1-inch gauge block. So on this you can measure obviously between the jaws. You can measure a bore diameter on the end here between these jaws. You can measure depth on the step here, or on the other end, depth of a bore. And the nice thing about these calipers are you can change from metric to imperial without losing your position. So if I zero that, change it to fractions, it's zero. Change it to millimetres, it's 0.01. Zero, it depends on the tension on here. So you could set this at 1 inch. Change it to imperial, 1 inch. And if you move between the three different scales on the metric or imperial fractions, it doesn't alter the position, it just converts it. So if you wanted to convert 1 inch to millimetres, just press that. 1 inch, 25.4 millimetres. On the top you have a locking screw, so you can lock that at the size that you want. Standard caliper, digital caliper. Look on the scale, it does have a ruler scale here. So it goes up to 6 inch, 150. Actually, it goes up to 155 on this one. And we'll try this on the lathe as well. Switch it on. Set it to zero. You can go into the bore. Give you the size in millimetres, or if you press the button, inches. You can measure the outside. You've got fractions of an inch. Millimetres or inches. Use the end piece measure a step, depth, or even the depth of a bore. Or the diameter outside. Or inside. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, hope it's interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.